Professor Hodgkin
should be much better known than she is.
Scientists admire the great determination and skill which has always been the mark of your work.
She was a highly intelligent, highly focused scientist.
She would keep going, whatever the difficulties, you just solve the next small problem and eventually the whole problem will crack.
Involving what can only be described as gifted intuition.
She was a peace lover. She believed in solving problems by dialogue and not by confrontation.
In recognition of your services to science.
She's the only British woman scientist ever to have won a Nobel Prize.
For chemistry.
What was it about Dorothy that made it possible for her to achieve the things she did at a time when so few women had those opportunities? Dorothy was born in Cairo. Her father was very interested in archaeology, as was her mother.
If there was a dig, archaeological dig, she would try and join in. She also had this amazing ability for recognizing patterns and symmetry, and her notebooks show that from when she was really quite young.
When World War I broke out, Dorothy and her then two sisters were brought back to England. She was essentially left as the head of the family. She had to worry about whether there was enough money in the bank account. Her interest in chemistry had started when she was only about the age of 10, when she went to a little tiny primary school where they grew crystals, and she said herself, "I was captured for life by chemistry and by crystals." So when Dorothy was in her teens, one of the discoverers of X-ray crystallography talked about this technique that allows you to see where the atoms are in the molecule and how they're arranged in space. And so she read about being able to see atoms and said to herself there and then, "That's what I want to do."
In lectures, she was extremely well known, seemingly having gone to sleep. And yet at the end, Dorothy would ask the most piercing question. She clearly wasn't asleep.
What personal qualities have helped you in the work?
In some ways, I suppose a certain kind of foolhardiness of going on doing things that other people don't expect is quite possible to do.
I think a lot of girls grow up with the sense that they don't have the permission to do things they might want to do. One of the characteristics that Dorothy's upbringing gave her was a tremendous sense of agency.
When she got married, she was asked to stand down from her fellowship at college. Eventually this was changed, and she also managed to be awarded maternity leave. She was the first woman to have that at the University of Oxford. It paved the way for other women who wanted to have a fulfilled scientific life and also to have a family.
After Dorothy's first child was born, she suffered an attack of acute rheumatoid arthritis and left her with distorted hands and feet. As she got older, the arthritis did recur, but she didn't let it hold her back. Dorothy was very much engaged in international issues, and so she was vehemently opposed to the war in Vietnam, and indeed visited North Vietnam. She did travel extensively, and she made a point of visiting, first of all, the Soviet Union, and subsequently China. It was the height of the Cold War, but scientific relations continued, and she was always very keen to make contact. Internationalism was a very big part of her makeup.
Dorothy remains the only woman scientist in this country to win a Nobel Prize.
The determination of the structure of vitamin B12 has been considered the crowning triumph of X-ray crystallographic analysis.
The Daily Mail ran the headline, "Housewife wins Nobel Prize." The reaction of newspapers in the 60s whenever women achieved anything was absolutely appalling.
Dorothy's influence on modern medicine is almost incalculable.
All the problems that Dorothy chose to work on were problems that would contribute to a better understanding of the body in health and disease.
Penicillin, the knowledge of its structure was enormously important in the Second World War.
Its structure was not understood until she solved it.
It enabled doctors to use materials that had been synthesized in a laboratory and apply those to the sick patients. The way in which those drugs are made now rely a lot on the structure that Dorothy determined. she gave the impression to those who didn't know her, perhaps, being a frail old lady, which of course she wasn't, but there was nothing frail about Dorothy's mind, attitude, kindness, and so on.
Dorothy should be remembered for blazing a trail, really, for showing that women can be scientists and not only be scientists, but be extremely successful scientists.
She gave to the world the knowledge, but also the way to do it, the determination not to give up. If you know and think you can do it, keep working at it.
And if that's not the definition of exceptional, I'm not sure what is.
Thank you, Dr. Hodgkin.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed that, be sure to check out these videos next. And if you haven't already, hit the subscribe button and click the bell to get a notification each time we upload a new video.